Come on, shake it, baby. Come on. Son of a bitch.
Chet, you all right?
Chet.
Yeah. But the car ain't.
Shit.
Should have stuck to crop dusting.
Position. This is Dr. Marshall.
And this is General Wilson. Exactly what happened? How many people were affected?
Michael Connolly, project supervisor. As far as we can go, I'm afraid. The rest of the area has been completely sealed off. As you can see, we've isolated this area. Michael here has been excellent in setting up the precautionary parameters. In fact, the entire staff have been extremely helpful. As many tests now as we can to try and find out exactly what's happened.
The dead one, that's Colin Finch?
Yes, that's him.
The other two, what are their chances?
Not very good at this stage, I'm afraid.
I want a meeting with all senior medical staff.
I've already arranged all that.
Would all research and administrative personnel above level 2 please report? transport to the Swanette room in 5 minutes. With all research and administrative personnel above level 2, please report to the Swanette room
Michael.
In 5 minutes.
2 hours ago, Colin had a cold and now he's dead. What's going on? Who are those people?
They're the military. Look, it seems as if a strain of our FM2 virus has turned lethal and highly contagious, so they're taking over. I'll see you there.
Come on, baby. Curve for Casey.
Could have been a hell of a lot worse. It was just a distributor cap. You know, we got really lucky.
Lucky? Shit.
Casey, we haven't been lucky in 18 months.
8,000 miles away from home. $75 between the two of us.
Stiff by a crooked promoter and stuck with a car that bust down before the show. Shit, we'd been lucky if the whole damn thing had blown up.
I knew what I should have done. Damn.
Well, I know what you should have done, Case. What you should have done was never left the States. You should have married the girl down the block, got a steady job as a mechanic with a steady paycheck, and never gone near a racetrack. That's what you should have done.
And what about you?
Me? Hell, I should have died a hero in that damn wreck in Daytona 10 years ago. Then I would have called it the Judd Pearson Screw-Up Memorial.
So what now?
Now? I'm going to the toilet.
I want to stress that the work you're doing is still institute work. We have not become a part of the military. We will continue to work just as we were. Mr. Thoreau's presence here is purely a security matter. In fact, they are here for your protection. That will be all. Mr. Thoreau and I will visit each department during the course of the day.
Finished, Michael. Even if all of this hadn't happened, we couldn't go on. We just don't want the same things. Don't. Just so angry about Colin. The whole project came from his research. Can't believe he's dead.
Look, there's been some superb research come about by accident. But there's always going to be disasters.
We have to steal it.
In the world.
Yeah, you could have done that in the Navy.
Hey, things aren't so bad. At least the car's working.
Well, we're not.
I bet this'll do it.
Doesn't anything ever get to you, Casey? Anything at all?
Yeah.
What?
Well, I haven't been with a New Zealand woman yet.
Hell, that. That's the same everywhere you go. Just a different accent.
You go down to the car, I'll just get my bag. Yeah, it looks okay. She'll do it.
Look, if we're serious about stealing it, we'll have to do it properly. Get it out of the country. I think I know someone who can help us.
Who?
Name's Barry. He's an American. I know he has contacts at Harvard and the MIT. You could finish the work there and publish it. I think it's the only way to neutralize it.
You think this is going to pull him in, Judd?
I don't know. We're pretty far south. No telling how they're going to react down here.
I can't get over those old cars. Boy, they're something.
That next gig is nothing but a plain old stock car meet. We'll be lucky to get $100 between the two.
Hey, remember to show up and tell your friends, all right? I snuck in the Tallahassee 500 to watch you race. In the trunk of a Ford Fairlane. My old man was with you then. You know that car had a 383, 580 lift, 340 duration in it, and all I could think about was being a part of your pit crew. Did I ever tell you that? To this very day, I remember you had a black Camaro. You and David Lanthrop going around and around and around. 200 laps, 201, 203. Just incredible. Got to 257 laps. I'm screaming at the top of my lungs. The most exciting race I've ever seen. I was hysterical this whole time. This is the best race I've ever seen in my entire
life. Hey, Jimmy,
tricks. Come on, mechanic. You can play cars again in the morning.
Sorry, how do you find the light in here?
Oh, I find the light fine.
I didn't realize you were so tall.
Well, sometimes things seem bigger in the dark.
Yes, I hope so. You've done this before, have you?
Well, once or twice.
Oh, well, then that makes us even.
Mm-hmm.
will be closed from now on between 10:30 hours and 1200 hours. And again,
it's okay. You'll meet your Mount Cargill at 3 o'clock on Sunday.
How will I know him?
It's all right. He'll find you.
And do I take it with me?
No, it's too dangerous. He'll tell you where to take it.
Aren't you coming?
I can't. Well, it's stupid of both of us, Co. Anyway, you're the one who can continue to work on it once it's in safe hands. We have to get you a driver, someone they wouldn't think of.
Michael, who is this Barry?
I've known him for a long time. Works with the American government. It's okay. He feels the same way as we do. What's wrong?
Oh, I don't know. I mean, giving this to an American I haven't even met, how can I trust him?
Well, stop worrying. Barry isn't our problem. It's getting what's in here to him that's the problem. So let's concentrate on that.
That's okay.
How are we doing, partner?
What's the second? 78, 79, 80. So it's $80 with the $50 down payment. That's 130. Right.
And parts and gas brings us right back where we started. Shit. It's open.
No, it's not. I'll get it.
Hello.
May I come in?
Sure, come on in.
How are you? This is Jed, Casey.
I'm Christine Wilburn.
Howdy.
I saw your show. It was very impressive.
Oh, thank you.
What's it down here?
Thank you.
There you go. Let's see.
Thanks.
Oh, a beer?
Oh, no, thank you. Look, the reason why I came is I want to hire you.
You like to hire me? To do what?
To drive.
You mean just plain drive?
Yes.
Well, see, we do kind of specialty driving, you know what I mean? We got contracts to fulfill and stuff.
Well, if you're
like
too
that.
Busy.
Well, how long would this take?
4 hours.
That's it, 4 hours. Jed, don't you think we could make an exception here?
Well, I don't know, maybe.
I'll pay you $1,000. I think that's what you would win in a race.
That's great. That sounds great.
Well, that's pretty close to what we could win. Where'd we be driving to?
Well, how about 2,000?
Jed, for $2,000, we...
Look, there are other drivers.
They... I don't drive blind for anybody. So if you got other drivers, I suggest you buy them, okay?
I see. Well, thanks. Forgive me for wasting your time.
No problem.
You just turned down $2,000. Do you know how many racetracks, how many cities, how many shows we have to do to make that kind of money?
Casey, we don't know what you wanted us to do for that money. I might have taken
$2,500. Shit. Steve, wait a minute. I spoke to him and pointed out all the pluses, and he said he would do it for $3,500.
Sorry, that's too much.
Well, you don't understand. You're not dealing with any ordinary driver. This is Jed Pearson. He's the best.
Well, if he's the best, what's he doing here? Why isn't he racing?
Look, you've seen what he could do. What more do you need to know?
All right, $2,500, but that's it.
The motor alone cost $10,000. If we blew that, we'd be stuck.
$3,000. Okay. I'll give you $1,000 now, and the rest when we get there. And no questions.
Find the ketchup when you want it. Now, there's that damn coil. I was looking for that thing. Chevrolet Cafe. Living in a garage.
Right! Guess what?
Well, with a grin like that, he either done something wrong, got lucky, or made a deal.
I made a deal. $3,000, $1,000 up front. The kid comes through.
Yeah, the kid got one up front. What do we have to do for the other two?
Nothing. Nothing at all. Just no questions asked.
No questions asked. That's the rub. No questions asked. Come on, your beans are ready.
Bean! Musical fruit, those beans. All right, it's all right here. You gotta be there tomorrow at 2 p.m.
You mean we gotta be there tomorrow at 2?
What?
We're partners, remember?
You're gonna be driving over 100 miles an hour on windy mountain roads.
Right.
You know what fast cars do to me. I can't take it.
You can handle it. I got confidence in you.
I will throw up all over the front seat.
I'll bring it back.
Judd, I'm asking you, please.
Casey, no mechanic, no driver.
Please.
Casey, do you know what this means? $3,000. You know what that is? That's out of the toilet. Over the rainbow. Huh?
Yeah.
Good. Good.
Portrait?
No, thank you.
Christine. I'm Barry.
Are you CIA? You people don't exactly have the best reputation. How do I know you'll give me safe passage? I mean, what are you going to get out of it?
Your government is too small to handle a thing like this. Where might it end up? Stop worrying, you're doing the right thing. Find yourself a driver?
Yes.
Good. How much?
$3,000.
U.S.?
Yes.
Lady, you're some negotiator. You realize you're on your own in this. If anybody stops you before you can get to us, you can't afford to have any visible U.S. involvement. time, and there is exact. Can't be late. And Christine, this driver of yours, who is he?
An American.
Son of a bitch.
All personnel, attention all personnel. Revised security and evacuation procedures, as outlined in this morning's meetings, will be tested at 1400 hours. Floor wardens, please report to the front desk. Hailing Dr. Marshall, Dr. Marshall, contact office early. Advised that checking procedures have been instituted on all laboratory sample traffic. All culture traffic to and from the public hospital not certified low priority must be signed out by a project supervisor. Thank you.
Do you have a release for me, Dr. Rubin?
It's just low priority tissue samples. How's Sadie feeling?
Getting better, thanks.
You sure there's a place?
Positive. You sure you want to wear that hat?
Yep.
Why?
It's a lot less conspicuous.
Conspicuous? What about the car?
Well, that's the only one we got. Where the hell is she anyway?
I don't know. She gave us $1,000 to be here, we're here.
Sorry, bloody traffic.
Are you sure you don't need me to come with you?
No. Thanks for everything.
Good luck.
Here she comes, Judge.
Well, it's about time. Just about gave up on you, lady.
Let's hurry. This is all we're taking.
Yeah? What the hell is it?
Mr. Pearson, our arrangement was no questions.
Come on.
How long ago?
I don't know for sure.
How much time between the last time it was checked and when it was missed?
An hour, maybe two.
Who has access to the room?
Just the eight project doctors, no one else.
I want to talk with each of them.
One hasn't been accounted for.
Which one?
Well, I'm sure she just left for the afternoon. She's...
Which one, doctor?
Dr. Rubin. That's her.
I know it is. And that is another member of your staff who's been her lover for 6 months. Have you any reason to suspect either of them?
None. They're both excellent team leaders, pivotal to the work.
If they didn't take it, who did?
I don't know. You set up the security systems, you have to find it. We can't use the police. We can't let the public know what's happened here.
I'm glad you realize that. Railway stations, airports, every road that leads out of the city, right? IH-4209, white MGB hardtop.
Open it up, Kate.
You got it.
What are you doing?
You want speed? Give it speed.
All right, we're set. Start it up.
To talk about, lady. What's in the box?
Thank you.
we're just cruising. I'll let you know when we're going fast.
Information, Mr. Connolly. A friend of yours, Dr. Rubin. We need to know a few simple things. We have very little time, Mr. Connolly. We need to know where Dr. Rubin is heading. Quickly now, Mr. Connolly. Your life is running out. You know what I think, Mr. Connolly? I think you're paid by the CIA to be a spy and thief.
No, I'm not.
Did you know that our countries are allies? I think we should have you carry a message to Washington for us, just to demonstrate the dim view we take of such behavior. Not a public message, you understand. A sort of private note. Mr. Kearney.
Take a look at that map. All right, okay, now let's see. We should be here. Right, so we make a left turn on this road right here. That's it. What time you got now?
It's 5 to 7.
Right on time.
Lights. Stop here.
What's up?
I want to wait. I'm not there yet.
I'm not here.
I know what I'm doing.
Oh, I don't know what I'm doing. Driving all over this island, carrying a damn mystery box, looking for mystery people on a nowhere road. Who the hell are they, anyway? Is that them?
Yes. We can go down now.
Party. nothing in our contract about leading us into the Valley of Death and getting our butt shot off.
They're coming to you.
Mr. Carney, you shot at the helicopter. What we were seeking is in the car. You won't allow that culture to leave the country. Will you, Mr. Carney?
No, nothing.
Sorry. I had no idea anything like that would happen.
You lead us in a damn war zone and you're sorry. Telephone call? We could drop you off right here and leave with a clear conscience.
I must make a phone call.
Bull.
Please.
Just...
Listen, she almost got us killed back there, for God's sake. We don't even know what for. It's about time you started telling us what's happening.
I can't tell you anything.
You're trying my country patience, lady.
Radio 10-11, please.
Oh, come on.
plug wrench.
Wish I knew who the hell she was calling.
Hello? Oh,
Barry?
Christine, where are you?
I'm in a phone box in Queenstown. Listen, somebody knew about the dam. They shot up the helicopter and tried to kill us.
I know.
What's your number there?
45307.
Okay. I want you to stay exactly where you are. I'll see what I can get organized this end.
But
just stay by that telephone. I'll bring you back
in 10 minutes.
Feeler gauge and the sandpaper there. Thanks.
Sure, I knew how the hell we got into this thing anyway.
I wish I knew how the hell we're going to get out of this.
We're sure as hell not out of it yet. Doing anyway?
Waiting.
Did they find them?
No, but they haven't been seen on the road, so they must still be in the town.
Right, let's get over there then.
Brains, we would have left by now.
We couldn't do that.
Why? You think she gives a damn if she almost got us killed?
She said she was sorry.
Sorry, yeah.
Listen, Christine, I'm sorry I took so long. Are you okay?
Well, what are we doing now? Look, if they get just before you...
Christine! Chris, listen to me.
You're going to be just fine. I can get somebody to you within an hour.
Yes?
Now listen. I want you to go up the other end of town.
Yes.
We got them. Near the lake. She's in the phone box and the car's parked near the wharf.
Where to?
Someone's coming to pick me up in 1 hour, far end of town.
Like last time, huh? Okay.
Following us?
I don't know. We'll find out.
Okay. Right.
Thank you. lady. End of the line. What the hell's going on?
I don't know.
Either you tell me, I dump you in the box right here.
Fine, you can do that, but surely you must realize it's a pink and black car they're looking for, not me. The safest thing for you would be to let me drop you off.
And take Shaker? Forget it.
Dad? Dad? Oh! Don't touch... Dad! Please!
You all right?
Yeah. Can you drive?
You gotta be kidding.
I'm not kidding. I need you to drive.
Well, then you better talk to Jed.
He won't listen.
When you say something worth listening to, he will. You know you need him as a driver a lot more than he needs to know what's in that damn box.
So what do you suggest I do?
I think you've done too much already. You just have to talk to him. That's all.
Chad, I think I ought to explain to you what's been happening. I'm a research scientist, and I was involved in an experiment on the body's ability to fight diseases, which had a freak result. Three of our team died overnight. What we'd stumbled on was a virus which destroys the body's immunity systems. The military wanted to develop its potential as a weapon, so I stole it, and I'm trying to get it into safe hands. And that's what's in the box. Now, I'm very tired, and I'm very frightened, and I'm bewildered by what's been happening, but I can't walk away. I have to finish it, and I need your help.
Stole it, huh?
Yes.
Well, you need help, lady. You got that right. Tell you one thing right now. It's a lot more help than I can give you.
I've got that help. I just need to get to a phone box where I can make a call without being shot at.
Let's go. Let's go.
Where is she? Is she all right?
We've lost contact. Thoreau got there ahead of us, didn't he? They're out there. Heading north.
Well, can you find her?
We'll find her. If we stick close to Thoreau, we may be able to jump in ahead of him. If we do, I want you to help us.
Oh, of course. Anything.
Good. Come on. Somebody I want you to talk to.
We had an agreement. You were to get her out with the virus.
It's not that simple anymore.
But we had a deal.
So sue us. Listen, Michael. You've been taking our money for a long time now. This is your chance to do something to earn it.
But you can't just abandon her.
All we want is the virus. We'll do what we can for her.
It was you that got her into this. All you gotta do is talk to her.
We need the box at any cost.
Let's go.
Thank you.
heading that way, right?
This is the first chance they get to turn off. They've been spotted on the coast road.
What have you told the police?
The man has abducted the woman. The boy is an accomplice and we suspect them of multiple rape.
That should get their blood going.
Casey.
So why did you leave racing?
Some scenery, huh?
Well?
Just leave it alone, all right, lady?
I remember the first time I saw this
country. Well, you can hardly blame me for asking. I mean, what you're doing is so obviously beneath you.
Like I said, the first time I saw this country...
Kill my best friend.
How did that happen?
At Daytona. He was my pit crew chief. Came in the pits for fuel.
It wasn't his fault. It could have happened to anybody.
Came in too fast. I was in the lead. I was hungry for a win, and I came in too fast.
It wasn't your fault. He was in the wrong place.
I came in too fast. That's what happened. That's what killed your father. About time you knew that.
I'm sorry.
Forget it.
Amazing!
We haven't done anything wrong.
Now we got the police looking for us. Lady, is there anybody in this country who doesn't want to nail your hide to the wall?
Go.
Are you kidding? Those gray goons and cops will be everywhere.
They're definitely in the container terminal area, sir. We have positive sightings by police patrol. Out.
Hey, isn't that a boat loading over there?
Well, I'm glad somebody in this car's got brains.
Ground patrols now, sir. No sightings.
Don't give me that. Find them.
Your request regarding ship movements, sir. Only one. A freight and vehicular ferry bound for Wellington.
Got them.
Name Spirit of Free Enterprise. Out.
I've got them.
Spirit of Free Enterprise calling. I'm Captain Cowan. And we do seem to have the car you're looking for, Mr. Thoreau. Two American men and a woman came on board with it. It's a pink and black car. The company's confirmed your authority. What would you like me to do? Over.
Arrest them and deliver them to Wellington. No one is to go near that car. Is that fully understood?
Very good. I've got a couple of lads who'd love to look after them. Over and out.
Right.
Hey, take it easy on the lady, will you, pal? You all right?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Yeah, Joe?
Yeah.
Think room service will bring us a couple of beers?
Not gonna go to sleep.
You bet your sweet bippy I am. I finally found a seat that doesn't have a throttle, brake, or stick shift, and I'm gonna snooze.
We haven't got time to go to sleep. We've got to do something.
What do you want me to do? Break down the door, jump overboard? I gotta tell you right now. I may be a fast driver, but I am one pokey swimmer, all right? You gotta face it. We're at the end of the road.
Christine, you take the bed. I'll go near the room.
Who's flying that chopper that you wanted those mystery bugs delivered to?
Someone from your country.
Oh, that figures.
The CIA.
You gotta be kidding.
I thought you'd be pleased.
Wait a minute, let me get this straight. You steal those bugs because you don't want your government to give it to the military? And you're gonna give it to the CIA? What do you think they're gonna do, bake Christmas cookies?
Well, there was no one else I could go to.
Come on, lady.
I had no time, there was no choice. I had to trust them.
I don't believe you. I mean, you're gutsy. But you're gullible, lady. You're really gullible.
I'm sorry I got you and Casey involved in this.
Sorry. It happened, huh? Just sorry it didn't work out for you.
They'll be waiting for us, won't they?
Yeah.
Just going home.
us.
Tunnel unless I see a goddamn train.
Here comes the hospitality wagon. Jesus, what am I making jokes for?
All right, hunker down. A bootleg of my life, but I never delivered a bunch of damn bugs.
What's that?
Richard. 350 cubic inches of Chevy in there, sir. A bit throaty for the suburbs.
Drive carefully. You see, that's the kind of guy needs that kind of car. This is the sort of thing you want over here.
Charlie.
got back there, Kate?
I think it's Capri. It's been souped up.
Let's see what he's got.
You gotta speed up. He's catching up to us.
Can't. Balls to the wall now. Back there.
About a half a dozen or so.
Let them open.
Got them. They're in a shed on the plateau.
Have you got a knife?
Yeah.
Get your coat, Jed. Hold on.
Careful, it's really sharp.
It's all the same to you, lady. I just didn't wait for a proper doctor,
Paul,
okay?
I am a doctor. Really, I am.
There's no end to your surprises.
Okay.
Why'd you want to be a doctor anyway, lady?
Because I wanted to save the world. Why did you want to race?
I wanted to win.
Did you?
Not so as you notice.
Section commanders, group your men.
Ow! Oh, oh.
All right?
Yeah, yeah. Thanks a lot.
If we ever get out of this mess, and we all link up together again, well, if you need a ride, well, give us a call.
You know what I would like? I'd like to watch you race sometime.
There's nowhere to go, Dr. Rubin. Do you really believe your CIA friends care what happens to you?
No, Casey.
Think about it, Dr. Rubin. I'm only interested in recovering the culture. I mean, no harm to you.
Gotta go, come on. You're gonna have to drive. Come on! Go, damn it, go!
To sink in, lady. They don't give a shit about us.
Fuck! Just keep driving. I'm gonna fix them.
What the hell are you doing?
Well, it was just an idea. When the snow